still cannot understand why you will have the princess of Enyatta kingdom sit in front of you all day for you to draw her image, only for you to come up with this thing as her. Ikenna, what is the problem?
Ozodema, I am as confused as whatever you are thinking right now.
What do you mean by that?
You know, while I was drawing her, I was very much sure that I was focusing on her while drawing this image. But I didn't know what happened. I didn't know how I came up with this.
See, what you are saying sounds so funny to my ears. But I will advise you to go and see the princess and explain this to her. Because what you did was a total disrespect to her personality.
But it wasn't intentional.
Explain that to her when you see her. Alright? Meanwhile, do you have food at home? I'm asking you now, do you have food at home? Don't worry, don't answer me. I can find my way.
Tell me, Ikenna, why is it that a young, handsome man like you is still single and you don't seem to be searching?
I've told you before that I've not seen the woman of my dream. Immediately I see her, I am going to get married to her.
And who is this woman of your dream you always talk about? What does she look like? What do you want her to look like? What qualities do you want her to possess? And have you seen her before?
She's very tall, very fair, extremely beautiful, with a heart of gold. She's intelligent, she's God-fearing, she's a wonderful person. She possesses everything I want in a woman. She's highly gifted and favored by the gods.
All these qualities in a maiden. And you speak of her as if you've seen her before. Have you?
I've never seen her before. I only see her in my dreams. I call her my perfect woman, the light of the world.
You can start with the drawing. What exactly was the meaning of what Ikenna did to me today? Did he actually do that to insult my personality? Or was it just a mistake? No. That wasn't a mistake. That That was a deliberate act. He knew what he was doing.
Honestly speaking, I didn't know what happened that day. I didn't just understand what happened.
Ekin, I think I understand you. Okay?
She herself, she didn't even understand what happened. She thinks I deliberately did it.
See, to be sincere with you, if I were to be in her shoes, I would feel the same way.
Seriously?
Yes. And even you, you will feel the same or even react worse than she did. The best thing I think you should do is to go and apologize to her, just like Ozodima, your friend, advised you to.
Can't you ever change this topic? Can't you? Better still, go to a place I can't hear this conversation and have your discussion. I mean, I'm tired of this princess screwing out issues. What is it now? Look, I don't have a problem with her. But I mean, I'm tired of hearing this arrogant princess issue. I'm tired.
What is going on here?
Ozo.
Nothing else. She's asking us to
why
change.
Why is his face like this?
She wants us to change the topic of our discussion.
What were you guys discussing about?
We're just talking about what happened between Princess Irene and Ikenna. That's all.
Ikenna, if people don't change this topic, I will leave this case for you.
Has it gotten to that?
It has.
No, nah, it has not gotten to that. Okay. I am sorry. We'll change the topic. Are you okay now?
It has not gotten to that now. Take it easy. I'm a guy, the empty. I'm hungry. You will not touch your son, Ime. So won't adjust, Don't worry. Baby.
Hey!
Agne.
Obin. Hoping the gods has finally smiled on us.
Father, what do you mean by the gods have finally smiled at us?
Hey, wait. I'm just from the palace.
Yes.
And Igwe said the marriage rites can commence now. The princess has finally given her consent to everything.
Are you serious right now?
Moa, Nukumau. I'm a big masquerade. Masquerades don't lie. I don't lie. I cannot lie.
Father, I am. Hey, Father, this is the best news. Father, this is the best news I've heard in recent times. Father, I am the happiest man in the Inyato Kingdom right now.
I can't say it. You don't need to tell me.
What do we do next? I mean, where do we start?
Are you not a young man of Inyato Kingdom? The first thing you do is you take her to Gugu Shrine for proper presentation to the gods. There and then, you propose to her, and her acceptance will take us to the next level.
My father! You see why I'm always proud of you?
I'm proud of you, son.
Father, can we do that right away? Can we do that today?
Don't be in a hurry. Igwe said we should start everything the next half market. So be patient, sorry. Be patient,
master. Father, I cannot wait for that day to come. Father, this calls for celebration. Let me get you.
Hey, don't worry. I'll take my own drinks inside. Let me pull off my legalia. Enjoy yourself. Anyway, it is not easy.
Thank you, Father.
Princess, I am so happy. I'm so happy that you have accepted to marry a young man. Father said the marriage process will commence in the next Afo Market day.
Yes. He will propose to you officially before the shrine of Ogogo. So it's our tradition that every young man of this kingdom that want to marry a maiden of this kingdom must go through that ritual. If the maiden accepts him before the gods, then the marriage is sealed. But if she rejects him before the gods, then there's a problem.
Mother, what do you mean there is a problem if the maiden rejects the man?
My daughter, I wouldn't want to go into that. Because no one prays for such to happen to his or her own person. The most important thing here is that you have accepted to marry the young man. And I'm so happy about it.
Why do you feel so much hatred for Princess Zorella? Do you see her as a threat?
I don't like her. She's full of herself and she's arrogant.
Well, I don't see the princess that way.
Good for you. Come to think of it, why did you say I see her as a threat?
Uju, have you developed feelings for our friend Ikenna?
Is anything wrong with that? Ikenna is a man every maiden of this land would want for a husband.
Oh, wow. I said it. Now I know why you don't want to hear anything about the princess. Especially when it has something to do with Ikenna. You are scared she will take him away from you. My friend, why not just tell Ikenna how you feel?
You know, sometimes I wonder the kind of person that you are. How would you ask me to do such a thing? Ikenna is just a friend to me, just as he is to you. Yes.
Well, if you actually feel something for Ikenna, there is nothing wrong with you telling him how you feel.
Amara, is it possible we change this topic? Is it?
Well, the truth is bitter. But it must be told. Right? I'm your friend. I will always follow you around. You have fallen for him. I am very sure of that. Would you? You cannot run away from me, though. I know that.
So go to the room, my bedroom. Pack those clothes on the floor and wash them, okay? What are you doing here?
Greetings, princess.
Hold that stupid greetings of yours to yourself. What are you doing here?
Please, can you...
What did you bring your rickety self into this compound to do? You cannot get out before I do something stupid.
Please, can you calm down and hear me out? Please.
And what nonsense can a son of a nobody possibly want to say to me?
Princess, I know I made you angry, okay? What happened the other day wasn't intentional at all. But that's not the reason it should be raining insults on me because I've come to say sorry for what I did to you.
How dare you talk to me in that manner? How dare you? How dare you speak to me like this in front of my mates?
What did you just do?
Oh, what did I just do? Well, I will do it again and I will do even worse if you don't get your wicked self out of this compound right now.
You see, I still can't understand why the gods allowed you to possess such level of arrogance. Yes, because this is one thing I hate about you. I'm telling you. Genti, don't even try it next time. If you dare try this thing next time, you can get Meggy, you'll be surprised. Allah. Don't try it, oh. Try it next time, I'll just slap the hell out of you. Ulana, you be here with you, Allah. Thank you.
And what are you two looking at? No, what are you looking at? Huh? What are the two of you looking at? May the gods blind those eyes of your stupid idiots. Now get out of my face! Get out before I do something nasty.
Tells me all is not well with you. What's the problem?
I've never been humiliated like this all my life.
What do you mean by that statement?
I wonder what the land of Enyato will become in the future if the character like Urena finally becomes the queen of this land.
Ikenna, what's going on? Why speak of your very good friend in such manner? I thought she was your favorite.
Are you mocking me or what?
This is serious. What is going on?
Anyway, I went to see Princess Urena and to apologize about what happened the other day. She rained all sorts of insult on me and even slapped me. Why are you laughing? What's so funny?
Sorry. I'm just happy you've gotten what you wanted. You know, I've told you severally that that girl is arrogant and full of herself, but yet, none of you want to listen to me. I'm happy she has shown you a little of her real self. Yes.
Junwa, I least expected this from you.
What were you expecting, Ikenna? Please, I'm on my way to deliver a message to Mama Isu. I have to go before she leaves the house. Okay? I'll see you, my very good friend. Very handsome friend. I'll see you, okay?
Went too far. She shouldn't have slapped him. Yes.
My dear, I understand what you're saying. Eh? But don't you think that the princess did what she did because she was badly hurt by that young man?
How?
As in, what do you mean?
Is it not obvious that the princess lost and wants Ikenna so badly?
Does that justify what just happened out there? Excuse me. If the princess loves Ikenna, as you claim, she should have been matured enough to tell him. Better still, she should have allowed Ikenna notice the love she has for him, and maybe Ikenna would have given her a chance. Mm-hmm.
My dear, what you are saying is supposed to happen the other way around. But how do you expect the princess to do that?
Nkoli, if someone wants something so badly, he or she should go for it.
Simple. Mm-hmm. All I know is that what she did, Odiroma, yes, the young man messed up by drawing whoever he drew, you know, but he came to apologize. Okay, it wasn't okay.
Mm.
It wasn't good.
It was not good.
I don't support evil. You know me, I don't
support. No, I support.
It's like you support.
Hey.
Are you okay?
Awoma, is it you? Hey.
Are you okay?
Hey.
the problem?
Amachi, look, don't worry. Just go in, inside.
Because I know I cannot take that, right? What do you want to try? But talk to me. What's the problem? You look so scared. Are you scaring me too?
I had a very terrible dream.
Terrible dream?
Yes.
Like, right here?
Yes. I just dozed off moments ago and I saw my wife in the dream chasing me with a cutlass. Yes. She made an attempt on my life. She wanted to kill me.
Huh.
I mean, she even gave me a cut.
Huh. Brother, that is serious.
Yes.
Brother, this is a very bad dream.
Yes.
Something is wrong somewhere. Yes.
You think so?
Think so? You're asking me if I think so, brother. But I know so. If you want me to go be sleeping now, brother, something is not right, so.
Hey, Ikenna. I am telling you. I came face to face with death last night, Ikenna. Ikenna, you would have been crying by now for losing your best friend to the cold hands of death. If not for that maiden that came to my rescue.
May the gods forbid. What is really going on in this land?
I don't know, but something is really going wrong. How do you explain that fact? How did the python get into my house? How do you explain that? Our kingdom is not known for having python. So how can you explain that?
This is really giving me serious concern. Seriously. Well, come to think of it, who was the maiden you said that came to your rescue?
Same maiden that's always saved people from troubles. You know, because I saw the same ray of light that they talk about. But the only different thing here is that I saw her face.
Yes. Are you serious?
Very serious. I saw her face. She's so beautiful. Very beautiful. As a matter of fact, Ikenna, I have never seen any maiden in this kingdom as beautiful as her. No, this maiden can be likened to that imaginary bride you always talk about. Very beautiful, beautiful maiden.
I don't get the picture. So you're here to mock me, right?
Oh no, far from that, Ikenna. How can I mock you? I am telling you the truth.
Are you sure you're telling me the truth?
Absolutely, I cannot lie to you.
You are sure?
Absolutely, I am sure I can't lie to you.
Okay. Just wait for me. I'll be right back.
Okay?
Hey, where do you think you're going?
I'm going to somewhere very important. Just take care of the house. I'll be back.
Ikenna! Ikenna!
Greetings, Your Majesty. May you live long.
And where are you up to this early morning?
I am going to visit a friend of mine, and it is very important I go now.
Oh, not yet, Uhuru.
I don't understand, Father. What do you mean?
Are there not enough troubles in this kingdom now to start this?
Father, I am grown enough. I'm an adult. I can take care of myself.
That's not what I'm talking about. There was an attack on your life by a strange spirit. And many people have been attacked by the same spirit that we do not know. Just last night, two people were killed by the same spirit. I do not want anything to happen to you. And remember, tomorrow is just a marriage ceremony that is about to happen between you and Obinna.
Father, I know. But it is very important I visit this friend of mine. I promise I'll be very careful.
This discussion is over. Go back to your room.
Father.
Masquerade of Enyata Kingdom, the one that sees the past, the present, and the future. I greet you.
I greet you too, noble son of Udumobiako, the very one that has found favor in the eyes of the gods. What has brought you to the shrine of Ogbu this time?
A certain strange spirit that have been saving people from this land. The strange spirits have been saving people from evil spirits that kills us in this land. Please, who is she?
You started your story by first talking about a certain strange spirit that has been saving our people. And you ended up asking me about the maiden. Why are you sounding this way?
This strange spirit is a maiden I'm talking about. She saved my friend from a big python. And he told me that he saw her face. That she's a very beautiful maiden. So please, I wish to know, who is she?
Are you telling me you left your house to this place to ask questions about your friend and his dreams or experiences last night? Don't create the impression that you, the next leader of the noble masquerade group of this land, does not know the right thing to do, does not know what to think about, what is important and what is less important.
The eyes of the gods, that which you consider less important, is very important to me right now. Please tell me, who is she?
Well, the ritual, the ceremony, the purification, the psychic preparation towards you rising to the position of the next leader of the masquerade group of this land is at hand. So, go home, get prepared.
Mother, something strange happened last night.
And what could that be?
All this while, I've been going to save lives in Enyata Kingdom. No one ever saw my face clearly. In fact, I can beat my chest and say they don't know me. They can't even tell if I'm a spirit or human.
I know about all this. What exactly are you trying to say here?
A certain young man whom I saved from a python bite in his house last night, he saw my face and he said I'm a beautiful maiden. He even asked who I am and where I come from. Mother, he saw my face clearly. Why did that happen?
The time is very close.
You are confusing me. I don't understand.
That the gods blessed you with a special power does not mean you are a spirit. You are a human being. The gods made you invisible to the people of Enyata. For the same gods to make a young man from the same kingdom to see your face clearly last night means that the time they have been waiting for
is very close.
The more I try to understand you, the more confused you make me be. What time are you talking about here?
For everything under the sun, there is a time and season. The gods will open your eyes for you to see all you need to know. Just continue being faithful to them.
Mother, why can't you tell me what I need to know?
My daughter, go to the kitchen and check what you are cooking.
Beautiful maiden, has always come to save my people in form of a spirit. Come out, I want to have a word with you. I want to see you. Who's on him? My friend said that you're likely to be the description of my dream bride. Come out. I need to set my eyes on you to know if you're actually what I have in my head as my dream woman. I need to see you. Please come out and save me this stress. Come and save me this stress. I want to see you. I know you're beautiful. I know. Save me this stress. Where are you? I need to see you. I want to see you. I want to feel you. I want to see what you look like. Come out!
Come! What's wrong with this young man? What is wrong with this young man? Is he going mad or something? Gods of our land, is this who is going to take over the prestigious position of leadership of all the masquerade groups in the Nyato Kingdom? Where do we go from here? Where do we go from here? On the one,
thank the gods for looking my journey short.
What is it?
I was on my way to your house.
And what business does the guard of Eniato have in my place?
Nibe wants to see you. He asked me to bring you to the palace at once.
Is everything all right?
I'm not in the best position to tell you anything. Nibe is. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Are you scared? Come.
Greetings, the King of Eniato Kingdom. I came as soon as the guard you asked to fetch me delivered the message.
Sit down.
Thank you, my king.
There is rumor that you, in particular, is talking about a certain strange maiden. You're crying to know if she's a ghost, a real human being. How true is that?
My king, I did not see anything wrong in that. And besides, I would love to see her. It's very important.
A man whose house is on fire does not go chasing rats.
My king, I do not understand what you mean by that.
Two prominent men of this kingdom were reported dead last night. And of course you know that these people are creme de la creme of people that make things happen in this kingdom. Their barriers are pending simply because the person who is supposed to be the new leader of the masquerade group is yet to emerge. Of course, the person supposed to be at the forefront of the ritual that will herald the burial of these people. Why have you chosen to leave that which is important and chasing dreams?
My king, please, if you do not mind, can you graciously talk to me in the language I will understand?
Why have you decided not to take a wife for yourself? Don't you know that this has been a barricade which is stopping you from emerging as a new group leader of this masquerade?
My king, I know. I'm working towards that.
Do whatever you can to stop this calamity that is before us.
Baby, why did you stop?
What kind of useless question is that? What sort of useless question is that?
What is going on? Why are you yelling?
You asking me? No, you're asking me what is going on. I mean, who is this? Who is this Tony you keep mentioning each time I'm making love to you? Who?
I don't know who is Tony. Did I mention Tony?
What? Did you just ask me that?
I don't know who is Tony. I'm confused.
Oh, yes, you mentioned Tony!
But I don't know who is Tony. And I didn't hear myself mention any Tony.
Really?
I didn't say Tony. I don't even know who Tony is.
What is wrong with you?
There is nothing wrong with me. You're the one acting up. I don't know who is Tony. So where are you getting this Tony from?
Okay. So if you don't know who is Tony, that means I'm lying.
I didn't say so.
No, that means I'm lying.
I didn't say you're lying. I didn't say so, but I didn't.
It's fine. Lying. It's fine. Listen. Since I'm lying, you see this house? No more sex! Leave it.
You can't say that.
What rubbish?
We continue. You can't say that. I'm your wife. If you deny me sex, do you want me to go outside? No, of course you won't want that.
Oh, Jesus. Don't!
You can't stop now. I didn't know. I did not mention Tony. So I don't even know where you get this Tony from.
Ikenda. Ikenda. Ikenda.
Oi. Who's up?
Huh?
Morning.
Good morning, Ikenna.
Don't tell me you're just waking up now.
I didn't just sleep well last night.
What happened? Don't tell me you went in search of that spirit cure last night.
I did. I searched like 5 families, but I couldn't find her. Not even her shadow.
Genna, you're just an idiot. Hmm? You had me well.
Why are you insulting me? What did I do? What have I done wrong?
Go and get your cutlass. Let's go to the farm.
Well, I can't go with you immediately. I want to go and see Anyoko. I will join you later.
This wasn't our agreement. What is the problem with you?
It's very important I see him, okay? I will join you later. Just go, I'll meet up with you later.
Kenna.
Ogugu, the gods of my forefathers, I have come this day to present to you the princess of our great kingdom, the maiden after my heart, the maiden I have chosen to call my bride. I pray you this day, Ogugu, that you remove the spirit of arrogance and anger from the woman whom I have chosen to call my bride. I also pray that you bless our union to be the best in Eyato Kingdom.
Anyoko, please, I want to see you.
How dare you barge into this place? Anyoko. This sacred place. The board of the gods. How dare you interrupt such process?
Anyoko, I am sorry. I didn't even know that such process is going on here. And I never knew that my presence would disturb anything. Biko, I'm sorry. Walu. Oh? But I still want to see you, Biko.
I cannot see you now until this process is over. Leave at once. Boku yobi burasu. I want to see your back right now. Go, 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 go. Yes, it is your turn, my princess. Continue.
I wish to.
Father, I want to go out.
To where?
To Eniato Kingdom.
To do what?
Mother, something tells me someone needs my help in that kingdom.
You have never visited Eniato Kingdom without the approval of the gods. Why do you want to start now?
I'm so sorry, mother of mine. But I have this strong feeling that all is not well in that kingdom. That someone needs my help.
Daughter of Light, you have always lived a life prepared for you by the gods. The gods have always led you in all you do. Why do you want to change that now? Please, my daughter, don't change. Biko.
My husband, please believe me. I'm not cheating on you. You know me very well. You know I can't even cheat on you.
What?
Believe me.
What I don't understand is, who is this Tony you were mentioning? Who is he? Who is this Tony you keep mentioning each time I'm making love to you?
My love, this whole thing is strange to me. I don't even know who Tony is, let alone have anything to do with him. I am your wife. You need to believe
me. You don't know who Tony is?
I don't.
I think it is now obvious to me that you don't want to say the truth.
Brother, you are right. You are very correct. She doesn't want to say the truth. Mimi, why are you doing
this? My friend, shut your mouth.
When you start to get...
Shut your mouth. If you don't have anything to contribute, shut it there. You're not supposed to talk. Who invited you to this matter?
Nobody has to invite me.
See, shut your mouth.
Nobody has to invite me.
I am my husband.
Nobody has to invite me.
Talk to your sister.
It's my brother we're talking about, so you have to say the truth.
Olomachi, let me ask you. What truth are you even talking about here?
The truth is either you're cheating on my brother or you have a spiritual husband.
Olomachi. Do you have any evidence to back up this claim?
Brother, what other evidence do you need? What other evidence do you need? Okay, tell me, which woman, married woman, though, that her husband will be making love to and she'll be mentioning the name of another man?
Honey, you know me. You know your wife. I cannot cheat on you. You know me very well. Don't listen to your sister. Don't listen to her. She's lying.
Are you okay?
Don't listen to your sister.
How people still remember our tradition?
And what tradition are you talking about?
Brother, you know the tradition. The tradition that says the man whose wife goes out to meet another man and comes back to cook for the same man, that man will die.
God
brother, do you want to die?
My husband will not die.
Brother, do you want to die? Me, I don't want to lose you.
You know me very well.
Igwe, Anyoku, the chief priest of Ogugu, told me yesterday that the gods have said that the sacrifice must be made on the next Eke market day. Moreover, Ikenna, the son of Uduma, Obiako, must perform the sacrifice.
Excuse me? Why would the gods ask us to perform a sacrifice on a Kede instead of our usual Afode? It is so ridiculous that the young man they chose is not yet married. And you all know that a person of such marital status is not fit for such sacrifice.
You are very right, Your Majesty. You know, we cannot afford to make any mistake of this. So I suggest that Anyoku goes back to the gods and consult them again. Because we all know what will happen if something goes wrong.
But it was the same gods who told him exactly what Onowu has told us here. It's not the same gods, no way. So what are you talking about?
There's nothing wrong with Anyok going back to the gods. Let him consult them again.
Elders of our land, I greet you all.
Igwe, I greet you. Elders of our land, I greet you all.
My son, you look so solemn.
That explains one thing, which is anger. What is it?
Igwe is the princess. Igwe, the princess spoiled the entire process. She messed it up.
How do you mean, son?
Excuse me.
Everything was going on as planned. I mean, everything was going on smoothly until the arrival of one useless, stupid Ikenna Obiako, who came and spoiled everything.
Hey, my son, please. Yeah? Do not refer to the next masculine leader of our land as stupid. Please, accord him some respect. Inugo?
Obinna, what did Ikenna go there to do?
Exactly my point, Inugo. Nothing. I mean, absolutely nothing. He deliberately came there to spoil everything.
And you know what you have just said now is absolutely wrong. Because that was not what happened.
And tell us.
Father, the said young man came to the shrine to see the chief priest on something he said was very important. And the chief priest asked him to go and come back later, which he did.
So, how then did the ritual process go wrong?
As I was carrying the ancient cup of palm wine and was about to make my wish, it dropped and poured on the floor.
What? What did you just say? What have you done? What have you?
Somebody help!
No!
Father!
I cannot believe that Ikenna of all people will act the way that he did today.
It baffles me that after giving me his word of joining us here when he's done seeing the chief priest, he couldn't even keep to his promise.
We all know he has not done something like this before. I think something is wrong somewhere.
Oh yes, something is wrong somewhere. As a matter of fact, he did not sleep last night. He went in search of that beautiful spirit maid that always comes to rescue our people at the point of death.
What's that supposed to mean? Has he gone mad?
Yes, he has gone mad. His madness started the day I told him about my encounter with the beautiful spirit maiden. I made him understand that what I saw can be likened to the beautiful bride, the imaginary bride you always talk about.
It's obvious what is wrong with Ikenna is not ordinary. Can we change this topic and talk about something else, please?
Something else like what?
Any other thing other than this imaginary maiden thing, please. Yes.
Oh, in that case, I'll go back to work. When you girls are done resting, meet me up.
Oh, okay.
I will rest it tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yes, we'll wait for you when you're done. We'll join you.
Can no kwa.
Yes, when you're done, we'll join you.
Can no kwa.
More grace to your elbow. I said let's change this topic, please.
Ikenna, the gods have chosen you to carry out the sacrifice that will unmask the evil spirits of death that is terrorizing our kingdom. As I speak to you, our ego is down. And you need to get married before the next 2 Eke market days for you to be able to perform this sacrifice.
Please, no one should talk me into it. No one should just talk me into it. I saw it coming. And I went to see Ayoko about it. He asked me to leave the shrine on the note that I was disrupting the process of the official presentation of bride to Ogugu that was going on between the princess and Obinna.
Wait. Are you telling us right now that your intention of going there was not to disrupt whatever was going on between Obinna and the princess?
Why should I do that? Why should I do that? I had a dream this morning. In that dream, I saw the Igwe being dragged by one deadly beast to the land of dead. Then, I went to see Ayoko about it. That's all. I even disappointed my friend Uzodemma that I was supposed to go to the farm with. Who I promised to go to the farm with. Because of that, I disappointed him.
Ikenna, I understand how you feel. But please do not allow anger to take the better part of you, as that will destroy lots of things right now.
Ikenna, you mess with the wrong person. I'll make sure you pay for this. Ikenna, I will make sure you pay for this madness. It's rubbish.
Father, how did it go? Father, how did it go?
That young man had no intention of destroying whatever is going on between you and the princess.
Father, that's not true. Father, how can you say such a thing? Father, I saw it right in his eyes. I saw it.
Son, will you sit down? Don't talk over your father. Sit down. I don't see him as a liar. He said he had gone to Anyoku to tell him about the terrible dream he had about our king.
Father, what useless dream is he talking about? Father, what useless dream is he talking about? Can't you see? That young man was only trying to cover up for his lies. I don't believe him.
But why would he lie over the health of our king?
Yes. What do you mean the health of our king?
He said he had a terrible dream. That in the dream, he saw a terrible beast dragging our king to the land of the dead. So he had gone to tell Anyoku about this dream and met both of you.
No, Father. I still don't believe him. Father, I don't believe him.
What is wrong with you? What wrong have we done to you? Huh? Why do you derive joy in seeing your parents in pain?
Mom, what did I do? What have I done wrong? I don't understand what you're talking about. What did I do?
One more useless question from this mouth of yours, I will shut it up for you with a hot slap. Why are you bent on sending us our emigres? Eh? Why?
Mom, I don't understand what you're talking about. And the more I try to understand, the more you're confusing me. What are you talking about? Why are you coming at me like this?
Really? Really? Pray nothing happens to your father, the king. Pray hard!
Mom, are you blaming me for what happened to Dad? Are you blaming me for what happened to my father? It is not my fault.
Really?
Why are you blaming me? Is this what this whole thing is all about?
Really? No problem. Time shall tell. Princess, time shall tell. Don't worry.
Listen, bro, nothing will happen to you, okay? Absolutely nothing. You will not die. All right? So calm down.
My problem is, what if he's actually cheating on me? I mean, what if this is true? You know our tradition. You know how powerful that deity can be.
Cheating on you? I don't understand. I thought you said you were certain that she wasn't seeing another man. So, come on, where is the cheating coming from?
I said so.
So?
But it's more than confused. I don't know.
That means, you're making me believe that she's actually cheating on you with the so-called Tony. I mean, the Tony she has been mentioning all this while.
Listen, Obina. Truth is, at this point, I don't know what to think or believe anymore. Leave me totally confused and blanked out.
Listen, bro, nothing will happen to you, okay? Nothing will happen. I am certain that, sorry if I use the word certain, okay, but I'm convinced that nothing will happen to you, all right? You will not die.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm sure. So, what are you doing? I mean, are you free?
Oh, no.
Let's go together and see my princess. At the palace.
Now, Chalupa, hold on. Are you still doing this princess thing?
I don't understand.
What? Are you pushing this Obina? Wait, Chalupa. Don't you think this whole thing might eventually blow up? if you two get to settle down.
1 minute you're thinking about the deity. And the next minute you're advising me. Come on, bro. Look, nothing is going to happen, okay? Nothing will happen. I'm all in. I mean, come on. She's the woman after my heart, so what do you expect?
It's a dangerous game.
Come on, bro. What's that? Let's go. Oh, man.
Young lady, if only mortals can open up and speak the truth at critical times, then most of the ugly situations could be averted.
Great one. You're confusing me with your words. Please, can you talk to me in a language that I will understand?
The ways of the gods are totally different from that of men.
Is my brother's wife possessed? Like, does she have a spiritual husband? Or is she cheating on my brother?
When a sack is filled, it must be tied. That which is hidden must be made open very soon. In accordance with its psychic, karmic consequences. Go home and allow the gods to do their work.
Ikenna, I came here this night to know why you did what you did earlier today.
Okay, I will start by saying that I'm sorry for what I did. It wasn't intentional. I didn't plan for it at all.
I didn't ask you to tender an apology. I asked but a very simple question. Why did you do what you did today? We had an agreement as friends. We agreed to go to the farm. So why did you decline?
I said I'm sorry. Something happened, so I had to rush to go see Anyoko.
And what happened is more important than what we agreed on.
Okay, I had a dream. I was actually dreaming before you woke me up. In that dream, I saw the king being drawn to the land of death by a terrible beast. So I rushed towards Onyeku to tell him what's going on.
Why will you tell such a lie again now?
I'm a noble man of this land. I cannot lie.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Then what did Daniel could say about the dream?
He didn't allow me to tell him why I visited. Rather, he said I was obstructing the ritual presentation that was going on between the princess and Obinna.
Are you by this statement confirming to me that the princess has agreed to get married to that idiot? Why didn't you stop it? The princess wanted you to marry her. Of course, it was written all over her.
See, the king is very sick. We should be praying to the gods to heal him than sitting down here talking about one princess, Urena.
Greetings, the dream man of every maiden in Enyato Kingdom.
The princess of Enyato Kingdom, have you come to my house to insult me?
The gods forbid I embark on such journey this early morning. Ikenna, I came to have a word with you. I came to pour out my heart to you, and I pray you give me a listening ear.
Say whatever you want to say and leave. As you can see, I'm very busy.
Ikenna, it hurts so much when you love someone. When you love someone with all your heart, and they don't love you back. I came to beg you. Forgive me for what happened. I allowed my anger take the better part of me. I am sorry. I apologize. I'm sorry about it. But please. Please again now. I beg you in the name of our gods. Make me a happy woman. Please marry me.
Apologies accepted. You can leave now.
Ikenna. Ikenna, why have you decided to hurt me like this? Why do you hate me so much when I love you with every fiber in me? Why have you refused to open up your heart to me? Ikenna, please. Please make me a happy woman. Make me your wife. I beg you. I beg you in the name of the gods. Please, what else are you waiting for?
May the gods forbid. May the gods forbid that I have anything to do with a woman who has been presented to Ogugu, kneeling before me, asking me to love her, begging me to be her husband. May the gods forbid.
The presentation process was not completed. Ikenna, immediately I saw you, I couldn't. And as soon as you left the shrine, I followed you. I couldn't complete it because I didn't want to marry him. It is you I want to marry.
Princess Urena, what is wrong with you?
Ikenna, can't you see? You are all that is wrong with me. I cannot think anymore. Every night I go to bed praying to the gods that they make me your wife. Ikenna, you're the one I see in my dream. You. Please make me your wife.
Abomination. No maiden of this land has brought herself this low for a man. And I ask, why would the princess of Enyato be the first to create such stupid history?
Who invited you into this house? What are you doing in a man's house? I'm asking you, you stupid and useless girl. Oh, you now live in a man's house. A man who has not given a common cup of palm wine to your people on your behalf. That is how low and how disappointing you are. So you now force yourself on a man, right?
Everyone in this kingdom knows that there is nothing going on between us except friendship. The relationship between us is genuine. It started right from when his parents were still alive. And if it pleases the gods that we become man and wife, then so be it.
Such abomination can never please the gods. And if you think in any way that your charm will work on him, then you fail. Now leave this compound. I said, girls, get this thing out of this place.
Hey, can you maybe stop that madness? Leave this place before I do something drastic now.
Get out, my princess.
Hey, I said,
get out. Shoot off.
A disappointment is what you two are. To think that you stood there and watched the daughter of a nobody insult your princess and none of you did nothing.
My princess, we are sorry. But you told us never to say or do anything in situations like this.
Will you shut that thing you call a mouth? No. You now speak for her.
No, my princess.
You are her spokeswoman, right?
No, my princess.
The gods have gutted her tongue, right? She can no longer speak for herself.
My princess. Right? My princess, we are deeply sorry. But you went too far.
What?
Yes. Kneeling before him and saying all those things to say to him, he did not speak well of.
He can speak what of you? How dare you open that thing? You call him out to talk to me in that manner. Are you insane?
I'm sorry, my princess. I did not mean to insult you. I'm sorry.
I see what is going on here. No. It's clear now. You two have eyes on Ikenna, right?
No. Hey, my princess.
No, I did not hear you.
No, my princess. My eyes are not on Ikenna now. No.
I see.
My princess, the gods forbid that I have eyes for the man that my princess desires so much. I can't, my princess.
In the name of the gods that you just mentioned, I will spare the two of you.
Thank you, my princess.
But the next time something like this repeats itself, will you get out of my way? Get your rickety selves into this car.
Very disappointed at you. Very, very disappointed at you. How on earth will you join issues with the character like Rena? How?
Why are you blaming me for everything that happened? Why?
Why must you talk to her? It's because you talked to her in the first place. That was why she has to be got to talk to you.
But everything she was doing was wrong.
Then do you have to rub it on her face? Even before her mates?
Don't tell me you're falling for that arrogant princess.
Anyway, the gods of our land has not brought the person of my dream my way yet.
Is it possible we'll end this conversation so you can eat your food?
I'm sorry if I made you feel bad. It wasn't intentional though.
No, I'm okay. Just eat your food.